All right, everybody, welcome back to episode 3 of the Chasing the Bag podcast presented by Tech Hockey Guide. I'm Kellan Meloche, your host. I'm joined by my co-hosts, Nathan Cima.
What's up, everybody?
Bryce Baar.
What's up, guys?
And Dylan the Diaz.
What's up, guys?
This week, we're joined by fellow Michigander and future Husky, Owen Baker.
Thanks for having me. Glad to be here.
Yeah, we were excited to get you on, kind of talk. We've had a couple guys on now, dudes who are transferring in, seeing what it was about the Huskies, what you're kind of looking forward to, a little bit about yourself. So we'll kind of get into all that stuff today.
Are you in the market for insurance? Have your rates for home, auto, boat, or more been increasing way beyond inflation? If so, maybe it's time you spoke with Aaron Pietola and the team at Arcadia Insurance Group, serving Michigan, Minnesota, Wisconsin, Illinois, Indiana, Ohio, and more. Who better to serve you than a former Michigan Tech player? For more information, call 866-511-1069 or go to arcadiaagency.com.
Fibke Dental is a general dentistry practice located in downtown Rhinelander, Wisconsin, home of the Hodag. Look online at FibkeDental.com or find them on Facebook. They do pain-free dentistry for kids, adults, people that went to great schools, and people that ended up at Northern Michigan. Stop in and say hi between 8 and 5 and tell them THG sent you. That is FibkeDental.com.
I guess we can start off by just asking you, Owen, like what about Michigan Tech when you entered the portal? Were you thinking about Tech right away, or were you getting a bunch of different people coming at you and Tech kind of stood out, or what was it that kind of made you swing this way?
Yeah. So obviously, just went through the process of, teams reaching out. And when I saw Tech reached out, I was, really interested and wanted to see what they had to say. And I actually had the chance to go up there and check out the facilities, meet the coaches, and I felt really comfortable with them and felt like it was a good place to play.
Sweet. Well, I know we've had a couple people now say how much they, kind of felt like they vibed with the coaches, kind of had similar mindset. So I know that's good to hear for us as fans, that the coaching and can still get kind of the good recruiting trail for the players, even if, we're maybe not getting some of the guys we want, but I'm really glad that we're getting some of the guys we want. So I know when you hit the portal, we were all kind of like, oh, this dude Owen Baker, like he might be kind of pretty good. I hope we can at least get an offer out to this guy, maybe see if something will stick. So
that's credit to Kellan for shout out. Like he saw Owen Baker from Holland, Michigan. He's like, he's a Husky right away. And it happened. So we were super excited to have you.
The birthplace of the famous Patillas.
Yeah, for sure.
Yup.
You're going to have to carry on that howl. You and Chase are going to have to keep repping the howl, Michigan, because
for sure
we've had some good players come from there. So that'll be pretty sweet. You kind of grew up maybe around the same time as Chase playing, in lower Michigan, AAA. You might have been a little bit behind Blake and Logan, I would guess. But did you kind of know of them while you were down there? Of course, you're from the same place. Or are you kind of not really like before now or before they kind of started taking off in college? Like what was you like your like knowledge of them before now?
Well, it's funny. I've actually known Chase personally for a long time. We played on teams together growing up, but his two older brothers are a little older than me, obviously, but not too familiar with them. But Chase, yeah, we go way back. We actually would carpool to practice, so good buddies.
Okay. Sweet. Well, that was definitely one that we kind of saw, like, maybe did you talk to Chase before you were, I'm sure you did, but did he reach out to you? Did you reach out to him? Like, how did that kind of look when you were kind of narrowing it down on schools you wanted to get into here?
Yeah, he actually, when he saw that I was in the portal, he kind of reached out and just told me that he think that it would be a good place to play. And when I went up there, he kind of showed me around, showed me the ropes, and it was pretty cool.
Sweet. We should probably shout out Chase, congratulations on
drafted
there in the fourth round by the Penguins. That was pretty sweet.
Awesome.
Getting called. I'm sure it's awesome hearing your name get called up there. So
yeah, definitely.
That's something I will definitely never be familiar with. And I guess none of us will now because you're a little older, Owen, but that's got to be something just crazy, dude. I just can't imagine.
Oh yeah. No, he's a great kid. Super happy for him, and that was awesome to see for sure.
I guess we can start ripping some questions now. We have a bunch of people, just a bunch of listeners send in some questions, so we can kind of start ripping those a little bit. Who's a player, you were growing up, are you a Wings fan when you were growing up?
Yeah, I am.
So who's kind of somebody, maybe you were growing up, or maybe it's even now that you're kind of watching, you're either trying to model your game off or take some inspiration from, or who you kind of trying to emulate when you're out there on the ice? Or is it completely just Owen Baker out there the whole time?
I mean, obviously there's definitely some guys growing up and like now that I like to watch, but I don't specifically try to model my game after anyone. I just kind of go out there and play like a little gritty style that I like to play and just go from there.
Sweet. Well, that'll definitely fit in at Michigan Tech. It's a group of pretty gritty guys. You gotta battle, you gotta get back, play defense, but I think the guys have a lot of fun out there, so that's good to hear.
Yep.
When you're kind of, what's your like pregame look like? Because everybody's got a little different pregame. You have any superstitions? Or we're a big superstitious crew here. We all have a little different thing we do on game days or something. So you have anything like that?
Yeah, I guess you could say I'm a little superstitious. Not specifically with like my gear or anything, but I just have like a little game day routine I stick with, and I guess like a little interesting thing is I just listen to the same exact music in the same exact order every time.
That's a
Any
that's
specific songs, artists, who are they?
my way. I guess, a little bit of rap like Drake and like those type of artists, and then I like to listen to EDM as well.
Heck yeah. That's
That's
sick.
Yep.
That's a pretty sweet kind of mix you got going there for sure.
Thank you.
Just to kind of pivot back to recruiting, was Tech a school that was involved in your recruiting process, like initially? As you were coming into state as a freshman.
No, so I guess I kind of committed when I was pretty young, so I didn't really have the opportunity to have other schools reach out. So I didn't really get to connect with them much prior, but not till the portal, so.
Okay, yeah, because I just asked because it's been kind of a common theme with guys we brought in from the portal where it's like we're in on them before they come, like before they go to school, and then they don't maybe get the opportunity they wanted. Like I know we were in on Matt Campbell when he was at Quinnipiac, and then things didn't work out there for him, so he hits the portal and we were straight back in for him. And it was a seemed like kind of an easy move. So just curious about that. And then the other thing, we've had a bunch of guys. I think you were the third in line in the past couple of years that has kind of like formed a pipeline between Michigan State and Michigan Tech. I think you kind of infer the connection there is Joe coached Adam Nightingale in junior. So did that play any role in your decision to come to Tech, like a conversation with Adam, maybe just like about Joe or anything like that?
Not necessarily. I did find that out, which is pretty cool to see that he used him. But I know they have a good relationship, and I think he spoke highly of me, and I sp speak highly of him as a coach as well. And I got to talk to him, and I just, yeah, seems like a really good person and coach, and look forward to playing for him. So,
So, yeah, were there any specific things about Joe that made you really like Tech, or just the program as in general?
obviously, like, with what him and his staff have done, they've made the tournament these past few years, and like they know how to win. And for me to see that, and obviously with me talking to him as well, I liked what he had to say about my game and how they play. So I definitely thought it went well.
And you kind of got maybe a closer look than some other guys at the GLI, right? Did you play in those games or were you there?
Yeah, so I played in the semifinal game, but unfortunately I did not play in the finals, but I got to see you guys prevail over us, so
Yeah, of
hurt at the
course.
time, but no, that was a fun game and really good game, but yeah.
Well, sweet. I know you probably, you grew up in Michigan, so were you familiar with that tournament beforehand? Like you kind of knew coming in that this is kind of something that the whole, these kind of three big Michigan fan bases and then one other team kind of really rally around Christmas time?
Yeah, for sure. I've actually been to it before, back when it was at Detroit's rink. Obviously they moved it now, but yeah, it's a really cool tournament, and it was super super fun to play in.
So you've been in a couple, I guess you've been in Van Andel, you've been in a couple pretty nice, and you guys were in the Big Ten, so you've been in some pretty nice locker rooms. Who do you think, either Michigan State, maybe you've seen all the stuff, or who do you think has the best facilities as a player coming in there, you know, who's really catering to their players around?
As far as the Big Ten or just
I mean, anywhere, if you anywhere, but I figure the Big Ten probably has the most cash to kind of jam into those locker rooms. So,
Oh man, have you seen North Dakota's?
yeah.
Yeah, that's actually a nice one.
UND's crazy.
Yeah, I've never seen it in person, but it and the things they have is pretty cool for sure. But as far as like the Big Ten, there were a lot of cool places to play, and like with the renovations they did at Mon, I was pretty fortunate. It was really cool to see and to be a part of that. But cool place to play or like nicest facility. I think Minnesota was pretty cool, and out of conference, BC was really cool as well. So,
We played BC. We didn't play there, but we did play him. So,
yeah,
yeah.
and the
We did
tourney.
score.
Okay,
We scored
we
this
did
year.
score.
We scored this year. So we haven't
Shorthanded.
done that in previous years.
Yeah, they had a good
Shorthanded.
team.
That was a crazy hockey team, though, man. That was a freaking just workhorse of a team. They could just beat you down for 60 minutes.
Yeah, they had some really high-end players for sure.
And their goalie, I mean, as a freshman, being able to come in there and play as well as he did, I think is a testament to just like how good of a either recruiting or just of a program they're able to put together over there.
Yeah, definitely.
Well, and you played in front of a damn good goaltender all year too, so you're familiar
Oh,
with that.
yeah, Trey is he's special for sure. He's a really and as a true freshman, what he did was unbelievable.
Just ridiculous watching him play. You know, we all play watch him play in the World Juniors and stuff like that. And he, I mean, that's just it's got to be nice knowing that there's a guy back there that on a 93% of pucks, they're not even getting close. So can you kind of speak on that a little bit? I know we watched kind of a similar thing with Blake the last 4 years, but I would love to hear from somebody who isn't playing in front of him because him and Trey play differently. So I would love to hear kind of what you have to say about it.
Yeah, I mean, like I didn't think like his age obviously played a factor. He was always good on the big stage, but like to have a guy back there like that, like you obviously don't want to give anything up, but if you do, you know 9 times out of 10 he's going to make that save and gives you a lot of confidence as a team and stuff to do what you got to do, knowing that he'll come up big when he needs to, so.
And I know you said you're kind of a more gritty player. Are you looking forward to the transfer or the kind of just the change of game player or speed of game that, you know, coming from the Big Ten, which is a pretty offensive environment, to moving to the CCHA, which is, I mean, defense first, basically everybody but Northern, is kind of building their team from the goalie out, you know?
Yeah, I'm excited to. I know each conference has a little different style of play, but knowing how Tech plays and how my game translate, I think it's going to be really fun.
All right, Owen, I have a question. When you score for the black and gold for the first time, do you have a celebration lined up or no?
I nothing in mind yet, but it'd be a score in front of you guys' the student section for sure.
That would be sick.
I guess we can ask about that because the Munsters and the Misfits are pretty solid friends as far as like team, like student sections go. The last guy we had on, Derek, he was from Harvard, so he had never played really in front of a student section at home. You guys had the Munsters who were just killing it all year. What's that kind of like, just being able to, you know, have a student section rally behind you? Is that like really kind of helping you guys out there, or do you think you might not notice it that much?
I mean, I feel like just like the noise and the atmosphere, you definitely notice it for home games. But yeah, I mean, it's pretty cool. I feel like it's just part of the tradition, part of the school, just like the band, and it's just the vibe and like the feel of a home game just is different, I guess, in that aspect.
And I mean, you guys have that. I guess we have it at Tech too, but that rivalry between, you know, Michigan State and Michigan, that's a probably a 45-minute drive, you know, getting between the two arenas. So what's that like playing rivalry night, or even when they do Duel in the D, like going down to Little Caesars? Like that's probably a pretty sweet series that you guys have rocking. And then to come and then play them again in the regional tournament, I'm sure was just pretty nuts.
Obviously the rivalry is something that is incomprehensible, but obviously luckily we got the best of them last year, but it's always fun playing those guys. Like no matter where or when, you know it's going to be a good game. And like the duel in the D was at Little Caesars Arena, sold out. It was really special to win that. And obviously they got the best of us at the tournament, but yeah, the rivalry just makes the games even better.
Now you have played, I guess, in kind of a roundabout way, you've played in front of the Misfits and you've played in front of the Monsters for sure. Who would you say kind of brings more juice to an arena so far? You haven't seen us at full force, but
Yeah, it's tough, but from what I've seen, what you guys can do, I think you guys might have us a little bit.
it's good to hear. Appreciate you gassing us up. Even if you're lying, I still
No, for sure. No, yeah.
Let's see if I got any couple more. I know they kind of kept trickling in here, but
Oh, I had a question. So on your bio page for Michigan State, you listed your travel hockey coach as one of your greatest influences. So can you speak on who he was and what made him so special to you?
yeah, so I guess, I mean, not one specific coach, but just like the coaches that I had growing up, a lot of them like have experiences with higher levels of hockey and just what they were able to show me for the next level and what I needed to do and be better as a person on and off the ice really helped my game develop a lot. And I'll never forget them and still keep in contact with some of them today, but I'm super grateful to have been able to play for them.
Kind of going back to your younger days, Owen, who are, I guess you can pick a player from Michigan State too if you want, but if you had to say who are the top three players that when you were younger you shared the ice with who have now gone on and just played really well, who do you think those three guys are that are kind of just, they don't even have to be the best players, but maybe like the best dudes?
Yes. I guess I was fortunate to play with some pretty good players, but Frank Nazar is one that comes to mind. He obviously just scored his first NHL goal last year, but super good dude, very humble. He was cool to play with. Oh, there's a lot. My roommate last year, my two, well, three roommates. They're all two of them I played with in Waterloo for the last 2 years. Patrick Geary and Gavin O'Connell. They're really good players and guys that I kind of just grew up these last few years with that were good guys on and off the ice as well.
I have to say, I'm from Chicago, so I grew up a big Hawks fan. So I was hoping when Kellen asked that one of the names out of your mouth was going to be Nazar or Levshinov. So I'm pretty happy with that.
Yeah, no, they got some really good prospects for sure. It'll be fun to see.
We got Kane though.
We did, we
Kings
did. You
re-signed
were
Kane. Suck it, Cima.
my
Hey, we won
Isaac
three cups with
clown.
them. How many do you have? We're about to have one, man.
One next year.
One.
One next
One.
year.
Next year.
Hopefully.
If we can sign a
That's a
right-handed defenseman, man, that's all she needs. We have five goalies on the roster right now.
too
We get
many.
Trey Augustine and we get three more rings.
Yep, real.
Y'all.
Soon
You
to
heard it
be.
here first.
Well, Justin Hall's right-handed, right?
Oh, shut your mouth. I don't want to hear
We try not to discuss him.
He's the most irrelevant player in the league, man.
Dude, how can you not? You dumped the Jake Wall the Wallman contract.
We keep Petrie. We keep Hall.
I can't believe it. I just can't believe it.
How do you like with this Iser plan thing? How do you pay to dump Jake Wallman?
I don't know.
When's the last time like a legitimate top four defenseman on a reasonable contract got traded as a cap dump? That was the most perplexed I've been by a trade in a
I
long
don't,
time.
Sima, I don't know, dude. I
And they
get
got
hard to
where did he go,
visualize.
San
It
Jose?
can't be that hard. It can't be that hard.
Is he at San Jose now?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Damn,
And they
man.
got such good value for him too.
Man,
Like
the
3.2 mil
Ducks
or
are
whatever.
6 million under the cap, like the floor.
Just give him Hull.
And we can't dump Hall. Are you kidding me? Ugh, I'm gonna be sick. Sorry, Owen. We got off on a little
No
tangent there, but
worries.
little rant.
Little rant about
We
the
need
off
hockey
season.
season back soon, bro.
Get our hockey season back. I will
Soon
take
to be.
one little update for everybody if you're not paying attention. The Alaska series flipped. For some reason, it's at home now. They never
Oh,
said why. They didn't even like
really? Yeah.
no announcement about it. I
No one
literally
didn't
just
even
got an
know. I know
email.
that.
I literally just got an email that was like, you can buy tickets for the Alaska series now. And I was like, what in the world? I thought it was going to be Cactus Cup tickets, if I'm honest. Like getting the email that's all my tickets.
I thought we were going to be flying.
I thought they filled the spot. I thought they filled the spot the 18th and 19th.
At first, I was like,
and no, then they're like, no, we're playing Alaska. I was like, we were already playing Alaska. What are we doing, bro? We need a home game 18, 19.
We need something. It can be an away
game. It's good we got home game. Yeah.
We can be away.
Anything. Exhibition.
What happened to Simon Fraser, man? We were supposed to go.
We were supposed to go to Thunder.
Are we no longer doing that either?
Well, I don't know.
No.
To go is the right word.
It was just rumored at the beginning of the or the end of the season that we were supposed to do an exhibition there, and we were supposed to go to Canada, but that fell through.
That would have been cool.
Would have been sweet. Well, you have that off week. When you go to Alaska, you get the next week off if you want it. So, like, why not just fill that spot with an exhibition or something? I don't know.
No,
it's real.
But now it's we're no longer going there.
No.
Yeah.
So you get six out of
seven. Hey, more home games.
Six of seven.
More home games.
Now, so.
Yeah.
And the first game against Northern, it's surely an error on the schedule. But the first game against Northern is no longer listed as an exhibition. So I would assume that's wrong and that'll get fixed.
Yeah, it'll still be an exhibition because the schedule was full, but we had the option to add two more games because if you go to Alaska, it doesn't count. Yeah. Like the total number of NCAA games, but now that they're home games, they do count. So there's nothing. It'll still be an exhibition.
Okay. So you see him as dropping the knowledge.
We need more games.
We got, you know what we should play, man? Let us play the dev team. We'll get smoked. That's fine.
Whoa.
We can stay at Casa de Cima.
Yes.
I don't live anywhere near the development program. I live in Chicago.
I thought
They're in Detroit.
No, they're in Plymouth, dog.
Plymouth, yeah, we can stay at Casa del Diaz.
No. Who
said Livonia
for the Diaz. We can't stay at my
house. Yeah, I live like 5 minutes away.
Oh, Diaz.
5-10 minutes
totally
away from the arena.
At your house. We are totally staying at your house.
Hell no. No, we need college, not the development team, man.
We're
gonna get absolutely smoked.
A little back.
Stonehill.
No.
Oh, Evan or
revenge.
Evan
game.
Or return game.
Diaz, man, this is what's gonna happen, all right? You're gonna get a text. It's not even gonna be an email. And it's gonna say, Diaz, this is Jordy. Can you suit up? And you're going to be like, Coach, what? Coach, what? He's going to be like, not for the Huskies. We want to play the Misfits.
No. Are you kidding me? One-on-one with Owen Baker, bro. I'm going to run away, man.
You can't skate fast enough to run away.
I'll crawl. I'll slide. I'll do anything.
He's like,
I'm not
Scott
saving a shot, man. A D1 shot? Hell no. You're crazy. No.
When you get 100 shots from, let's say...
Blue line.
Yeah, we'll go top of the slot. You get 100 shots on the Diaz who can't skate. He actually can't even skate, and he's gonna be in net. How many do you score?
All 100.
I gotta leave room for personal error just in case I miss the net, but I over 80%.
Oh, that might be. I think
okay.
You're giving yourself enough credit.
You say 80%.
Yeah, 80.
I feel like that's,
he says
that's
80. He can.
No, I think you're selling yourself short because I don't know. I think I could say
one D1 shot.
Out of 100?
As long as you don't get out of the way,
the top
you're fine.
Of the slot?
Yeah, no.
No, at the top of the slot. Yes, I can.
I got you for one, Diaz, but it's just because Owen missed. It's not because you saved it.
No. I'll save one.
80% is kind of crazy.
He's gonna ring like the third one off your cage, and you're gonna be like, no, can't do it anymore.
That's probably true. That's probably going to be the first one, bro. He's like, oh, that's my warm-up shot. No, I'm gone.
That's great.
Maybe I wasn't as good as I thought I was growing up because I haven't played competitively in about 5 years, and I would have backed myself to score more than 80% on Diaz. But if we got a D1 player saying that he couldn't.
Sima, we can actually test you. I'll go
yeah,
make Diaz get pads. I don't really think we can test
all
it.
All three of us need to test it. Yeah.
Whoa. Let's calm down.
So, rank us three on who would get more goals than you.
I've never seen you shoot though, but I think Kellan will definitely get more than you. I'll probably say Cima.
Oh.
Cima 90%.
Did you see me in soft talk?
That's
man?
Crazy. That's crazy.
Remember Lud's barrel?
Oh, I did see you in soft toss.
That was pretty good.
I don't know. I'll be close between you But definitely Owen's getting 100 out of 100. Or not, I'll save one. 99 out of 100. I'm saving one.
How many?
Cima probably 90.
I can respect it.
Kellan and Bryce are like tied for like 75 for sure.
What?
Not that much.
75? Nope. Yes, I can't hit that.
Dude, I have the slowest reaction.
Diaz, I can't get the puck from the blue line to the net. You save 100% because I can't get it there.
Wait, is it? Okay, yeah, blue line.
Oh, I thought you said top of the slot, bro.
Either way, I still don't think I can get it there.
I don't know. You just need training, man. Owen can teach you.
Dude, I've been grinding. LT for our anniversary. LT got me practice pucks. So I've been grinding.
No way.
It's awesome.
Oh, and I just picked up hockey like in the last 2 months.
I just picked up skating last year.
It's fun.
Pick up skating wrong.
It's so fun. I'm so unbelievably ass.
It'll take some time, but.
I'm also past my peak. Like, I'm going down in skill level of everything. So, like, trying to learn a new sport's just not good.
Mine's a plateau. Mine's just this.
We need to get skating lessons from someone.
I think we should.
Down.
Dude, I told you we should send him to the Pete Eigner School of goaltending, of door opening.
And he never went. And you're supposed to train with Joe Sean, too.
He still has 2 months to do all that.
Yeah.
Earned. But, I'll hit him up. The arena's closed.
You're going to be up there this
weekend.
They're
doing renovation.
Hopefully
that. Yeah, I was going to say, let's go.
Yeah, Owen, did they make you guys move into Houghton, man?
I actually just got back a few weeks ago from track A, but I believe it's sometime like mid to end of August.
Okay.
Okay. So like a few weeks earlier. Okay.
So like the freshman move in.
Yeah.
And you're skating with it. Like as soon as you get back up there, you're skating with the team, right? I know it's like there's rules about official practices and stuff, but.
Yeah, for sure. And get all our gear and everything like that. And yep, start training for the season.
Have you picked your number yet or no?
I believe I have, but I'm not quite sure it's set in stone.
No leaks.
No leaks.
All right, yeah.
We don't, none of that. We haven't, like, they haven't published anything yet, so.
Right, yeah, I guess wait till it's official.
He's going to say, like, number one. We're going to be like, no way.
not number
Keep
one.
Keep it secret,
not
number one. One.
Number one.
Number one.
Can you give us a hint? Is it above the number 30?
No.
Okay, perfect. That's all we need.
It can't be, bro.
I don't think it's single digit.
No, don't ask him that much, man. Don't.
Oh, okay.
Not single digit.
We just had to make sure it wasn't above 30 because I don't think anybody can remember a tech player above 30.
Oh, Tyrone, bro. He wore 55.
And Tyrone was 55 for the first year after he transferred. He had too many damn players.
That's gross. We're going to end up with too many damn players, dude. I don't even think we're going to have an empty number this year.
That's fine by me, man. I love these players, man.
Yes, you're wearing number one this year. You're our walk.
Does that mean 20?
No.
Does that mean the cursed number is getting taken, though? 27?
Oh, absolutely. Owen, you're not 27, are you?
No.
Okay, good.
Don't worry. But I'm not sure, no.
As long as you didn't request 27. If you request 27, like...
There's a curse on that, Owen. Don't do it, man.
No.
If you want me now, I would put in a request to change it right now.
That thing's cursed.
You don't have to worry. It's I didn't pick that one.
What have we lost? Three? We've lost three 27s in a row or two?
Three.
Well, it depends on how you look at it.
Transferred, dropped, and transferred. Or dropped again. Yeah.
Transfer drop.
Just three sticky situations with players that wore the number 27. That's all. So,
yeah, it's a tough sequence.
Yeah, very tough. Maybe someone could break the curse. Who knows?
It's gonna come out. We're gonna see the roster. And it's gonna say Isaac Gordon switch numbers to 27.
It's gonna be
it.
Lori Ryman.
Oh no, dude! Not the goat.
Before we keep wasting all this time here, was there any more questions in the Discord?
Yeah, we're just
that were actually relevant. I'm not gonna ask Matt's question.
Yeah, I think I got all of them.
Shout out to Matt, though we're not asking him.
Sorry, MC.
Oh, there is one. It's not hockey related though. It's which TV show would you most like to be a character on?
Okay. I actually watch a lot of TV shows, but I would have to go with the Entourage. If you've ever seen it, it's an unbelievable show. Favorite of all time.
Anybody? I've never seen it, so I don't.
I've never heard of it, so
Hey,
I
Nander's
know it
watch
from.
party of the Entourage.
Look it up. It's on
Sure.
HBO, HBO
A
Max.
word. Diaz,
All right,
we got that on the
I'll see.
Fire Stick at Nander's?
Yeah, we sure do.
Word.
I have Max, yeah.
All right. We'll have to check it out. We'll be studied up by October.
All right, for sure.
All right, Owen, I have one more question before you go. I
Yeah.
just bought a hockey stick and it's candy cane, the Tate Jobs candy
Let me.
cane.
I'll find a
Do
picture.
you rate the candy cane setup or no? Like the tape job?
Yeah.
Do you think it's sty or no? Just a
I'm gonna say it's sty. It's different for
Yes.
sure, and not just because you don't see it that often. I respect it. It's different.
When
It's
the players
Let's
pay well,
go,
man. I feel like there's got to be
bro.
like you have to have like a certain aura to pull it off though. Like Phil,
You
Phil
do
Kessel
have
pulls it off.
aura. Here's
And
a
like
you do
Diaz
have
does.
aura.
Here's here's your picture
Diaz does,
of
yeah.
this candy cane stick, if it'll focus.
Okay,
It's like the whole way down.
that I mean, that's pretty crazy, but
Black Blade
let's try,
candy
yeah.
cane wrap.
Okay,
He's trying
well,
to have
I
Phil
didn't
Kessel
tape
aura,
it.
so.
I asked Cima to tape it. I thought he would do like Tyler Sagan's, where he just does the handle, but he kept going all the way down, and it
He
was
showed
already
me the
too late. So
candy
I was like,
cane.
I'm never.
He did. You did.
Yeah, but I thought you meant like Tyler Sagan's, but it's whatever. Sty, sty, man.
It's never too late to change, but if you like it, stick with it.
I think it looks beautiful.
He would.
I
Dave,
think
I
I could
haven't
score
even
a goal with
used it on the ice. I have more ice time with that stick than you do.
Wait till pond season comes, man.
It's a foot too tall for me.
It's okay. It's a little short for me too. It's like right here, like almost at my chin. But you know me, I'm bad with money, man. But that's my question. That's all. So I have no more questions.
Are you fashion conscious, Owen, or do you not care?
I guess a little bit, yeah.
Not like some we got some of these players that are like even off days, just generally they just got great fashion, you know?
You gotta
And
respect it.
yeah, I mean you gotta respect your grind.
It's
But
the Euros, man. They
it's the Euros.
care how
All
they
the
look,
Euros are
man.
like freaking just styled
Yeah.
out.
Yeah, definitely.
You'll get the team backpack. I'm sure everybody did. Everybody wear the team backpack at State with the number on it?
Yeah, they did.
We had
For
all the dudes
sure.
at Tech rip it, except there was one dude who didn't, and it was just because it didn't quite match his outfit. And I was like, no way.
Well,
That's
you
dedication.
noticed one that didn't have it on, and then he transferred.
No,
You
he's
can
still on the
guess.
team.
Oh, he's still
Yeah,
Lachlan?
it's Marcus, right?
Oh.
Marcus doesn't use it.
Oh, I
Oh,
guess there's
okay.
a couple then. The answer is Lori.
Okay.
I'll
Okay.
definitely
Yes. Yeah.
be repping it for sure.
Yeah, you'll rep it. You'll see. It's like I don't know. I guess at State it's a lot bigger, so you might not have. But everybody, you know, you're ripping the backpack, and you'll see you're like walking down campus, and you'll see people kind of like look behind you to see what number you are. They're like, that's totally a hockey player. I just don't know who it was. And I'm like, oh, Owen Baker,
Yeah,
number
it's
24.
definitely a smaller school for sure,
Is that something you're
but
looking forward to, or are you kind of?
yeah, it'll be a nice little change. I like how everything's just kind of in the same area and within walking distance, so that's nice.
For sure. All right. I think that's kind of all we got for you, Owen. Appreciate your time a ton coming on and
Thank you, Owen.
Thanks for coming on. It's awesome.
yeah, for sure. It was nice to guys see you soon at a game, hopefully.
Oh yeah, we'll be there.
Yep, we'll be there.
We'll be there. Haven't missed one in a while, so we'll be in Palm Springs. Keep us you want to party in
Oh,
Palm Springs,
you
say the
won't.
word.
Yeah,
I
right.
bought my
You
plane
bet. See,
tickets, Nathan Cima.
swear
I
to God,
bought the damn
I'll make
plane
it to
tickets.
Palm Springs.
I
Did
got
you
a flight.
actually?
I got a flight leaving Green Bay, Wisconsin.
Did you actually? Like,
You're
dead ass. Look me in
kidding.
the eye and tell me, dead ass, you did.
I bought flights to Palm Springs, California on January 2nd.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
Me
That's
and Owen
awesome.
Baker are going to be
That'll
partying up in Palm Springs.
be a fun trip.
It'll be so, yeah, it'll be really cool. I'm excited for it.
I'm trying to make it, man. We'll see.
Dude, are you staying in Houghton until January?
No, I'm going to go home and then go back up
Okay.
after GLI. Probably on the first, I'm going to drive up.
Gotcha. And then you're going to go down to Green Bay the next day.
Yeah, correct.
You're crazy.
I'll stay at Casa Cima on the first.
Yeah.
I mean, if you want to go You actually could stay here on the first if you want to go, if you want to come here instead of Houghton. Like you could actually do that if you want.
Yeah, I don't know when I'm gonna go back up. We'll see if I spend New Year's in Houghton or not. So it'll depend, but
All
pretty
right.
sweet. Well, Owen,
All right.
yeah,
Well, thanks, Owen.
appreciate it.
Yeah, thank
Thank
you.
you. Good luck this year.
Yeah, we'll see you. We'll see you come
Good
October.
luck, Owen.
Thanks again.
Yep, thank you. See ya.
Do you work in manufacturing, product design, or product development? Is your business trying to improve efficiency while also producing at scale? Livonia Technical Services can help. They provide world-class quality improvement training and consulting for failure modes and effect analysis, product development, and cost reduction. All things that could help Northern Michigan assemble a competent defense. If you think your business could use a prevention mindset and reduce manufacturing costs, a partnership with Livonia Technical Services might be right for you. Check them out at livoniatech.net. That's LIVONIATech.net.
One minute remaining in the podcast.
All right, Diaz, you wanna get a count us out of here?
Yeah, that's all from Chasing the Bag. Thank you, Owen Baker. If you're listening to this, please upgrade your tier list or tell your friends or family to get Patreon to help Tech Hockey Guide out. That's Kellan. Bryce was over here, and there's Cima. I'm in the car with Tyler. We're in the Top Golf parking lot. I was not driving. Thank you for listening, and we'll see you next time with our new special guest.
Good job.
And I made the tier list place this time.
Yeah. All right. We're going to start the...
You've been listening to the Chasing MacNaughton Podcast, presented by Tech Hockey Guide, covering the Michigan Tech Huskies and the CCHA. God bless the well-read, impoverished, the lonely, cracker jack rappers, certified phony, baloney eating, greasy face, watermelon spitters, to the lean cuisine mothers, eating ATV dinners, bless the sinners, saints, sniffers of pain, pacified punks in the quiet and the quaint. If you're late and lethargic and you always want to start it, maybe the 10% of your brain that you use is retarded. Well, I started and I just analyzed the issue. I agree with your mothers, we need tissue. I bet your mother miss you, and if she don't, then it kills you from the bone to the gristle. Yes, it's only in America. From the red to the white and the blue, with the stripes and the stars. From the red to the white and the blue, with the stripes. We're living in America. USA. I think it's time for the silent majority of this country to stand up and be counted. What is it? Why don't he listen? Why does it get burnt every time it's in the kitchen? Flipping on the other side of the story. When it's daytime TV, it's Montel, it's Maury. It's your crack addicted mom, the smack up in her arm, the devil inside of you saying, be calm. Catching visions of the life that's in front of you with the angel inside you. Say, what the fuck you gonna do? It's methco, oxy, her blyant, the epoxy, the pressure from your lover, telling him, get off me, it's your coffee breath. Lost the war, it's the law since Afghanistan, and it's the overall cause in America.
fellow Americans.